Native people. Native culture. Native knowledge. Hi, I'm Jeannie Green, bringing you award-winning Heartbeat Alaska.
Bringing you national and international Native news, this is award-winning Heartbeat Alaska, the premier Native voice in Native programming.
There's a heartbeat louder than thunder. Revolution is in the air. There's a heartbeat deep inside our mother. Are you too cool to care?
Now, with Heartbeat Alaska, here's Jeannie Green.
Hello, welcome to Heartbeat Alaska. Native news and Native information, I'm Jeannie Green. Well, 1998 is just around the corner. We have a special program today, New Year's resolutions from our viewers. Also, I have news updates. We have all that plus some music videos that we introduced in 1997. Don't go away, I'll be right back.
I met him on a powwow trail. He was singing and I was a dancer. To the heartbeat drum, heartbeat drum, yeah, yeah, oh. Long summer nights, falling in love.
Homeboy and the 5th and 6th grade students of Tyonek, Alaska, with Jeannie Green and all her viewers.
A very Merry Christmas!
Heartbeat Alaska is brought to you in part by the Division of Alcoholism and Drug Abuse and the Alaska Council on Prevention of Alcohol and Drug Abuse. Together, preventing substance abuse statewide. And by Ute Air Alaska, official airlines of Heartbeat Alaska. Ute Air Alaska, taking you home.
Before we move on, let's take a moment for some rural news updates. And though it's not rural, it affects Natives across the state. Native health leaders met in Anchorage for a two-day meeting to create a consortium to run the Alaska Native Medical Center. For 2 years, Natives across the state have been meeting to create their own management structure. Then, when tribal leaders had more than 90% consensus, Senator Ted Stevens attached a rider to the Interior Department Appropriations Bill, a rider that created a management board favored by the minority. Tribal leaders also did not like the level of control over primary health care and essential statewide health service given to the Anchorage-based South Central Foundation, a nonprofit arm of Cook Inlet Region Incorporated. Right now, the dividing of contracts is awaiting a clearer definition of which services are considered primary care and which are essential statewide health services. And even though very few Native leaders like the new structure, and several groups have legal reviews in progress, toward the end of the meetings, they are working to make the best of the situation. In Elam, Alaska, 200 villagers gathered to watch two students shoot free throws in the gym. That's not so unusual. However, in most schools, that would be easy. In Elam, the rebounded balls kept hitting people in the head. The 39 by 26 foot gym is so small there are no bleachers. People crowded into every empty space. In the Elam Elementary School, the gym dates back to 1966 when the BIA operated the school systems in Alaska. Citizens of Elam are hoping to raise $2 million needed to build a regulation-sized gym. Basketball is a big thing in rural Alaska. And beginning tonight, a potlatch honoring 88-year-old Harry Johns will be held in Copper Center. Harry Johns will be sworn in as tribal chief. The Native village of Klutika has not had a formal village chief for several years. The swearing-in begins tomorrow night at the Klutika Memorial Hall in Copper Center with dinner and welcoming of guests. And the swearing-in tomorrow night, the public is invited. And thank you so much, Patsy Cronin, daughter of Harry Johns, for that bit of news. We welcome News in Heartbeat Alaska. Whether it's a community event or not, whether it's an event in your family, let us know. Your news is our news. Just call 907-563-7440. Let's take a moment now to visit with some Native American recording artists that we introduced to you in 1997 and some other old friends.
Yeah.
Let's take a look at some of your neighbors and their New Year's resolutions for 1998.
New Year's resolution is to quit smoking.
To have a closer walk with God. I have the gift of preaching, and I teach at the First Native Baptist Temple. First Native Baptist, right across from the old Native Hospital. And just to save enough money to go to a Bible college.
The resolution is that I go back to school for nursing.
To get a new puppy.
New Year's resolution is to get my family back on track so we can all live together in peace and harmony.
My New Year's resolution, being a Christian, to get out there and start fishing.
To allow the Lord Jesus Christ to carry out the resolution for me instead of me doing it myself. Thank you.
Yeah, I guess if you were asking me for a New Year's resolution, the main one I would have would be get closer to God, my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Is to improve my relationship with my parents.
My New Year's resolution is to save more and spend more wisely. And I don't have any further resolution right now. I try not to make it and not, so I don't go back on it later and not fulfill it.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Heartbeat Alaska people from Sitka and Nome would like to say Happy New Year and have a great time. We love you.
My New Year's resolution is to stay as far away from the dinner table as possible, take off at least 30 pounds, and start box with Eagles.
Contact Heartbeat Alaska with your news. Heartbeat Alaska, 5861 Arctic Boulevard, Unit B, Anchorage, Alaska, 99518. That's Heartbeat Alaska, 5861 Arctic Boulevard, Unit B, Anchorage, Alaska, 99518. Or give us a call at 1-907-563-7440 or fax us at 1-907-563-9309. Heartbeat Alaska, your news is our news.
My New Year's resolution is to win souls for the kingdom of God and get closer, have a closer relationship with Jesus Christ. And I'd like to say a Happy New Year to my parents, Jesse and Emma, Jimmy and Betty Time, and all my brothers and sisters. Happy New Year, and have a wonderful 1998.
New Year's resolution would be to stay warm and not to freeze up here in Alaska. I'm from Louisiana, and I guess to get a four-wheel drive or something like that. That'd be my New Year's resolution.
Daughter Carrie, while you're in the hospital tonight at Providence, watch Heartbeat Alaska, because we're going to be on the news. I'm making a New Year's resolution that you'll get better in the hospital, and that we'll both get on an exercise program. It'll be a good year.
My New Year's resolution is to keep my teeth brushed every single day of the entire known year, forever on.
Hi, my name is Vernon Herbert. I own the Bush Bobbins Barbershop here at the airport. My New Year's resolution is that I'm going to try not to scalp as many people as I did last year.
To introduce to you Priscilla Coolidge, Laura Satterfield, and Rita Coolidge.
When they are
mine. Great Alaska and your beauty, may I behold snow-capped mountains, deep blue glaciers, winding rivers that run so cold. Hear the birds sing in the twilight of the summer's midnight sun. You are mine, great Alaska, and I'm proud to be your native son. Are mended, ready for the salmon run. You are mine, great Alaska, and I'm proud to be your native son. I have braved your coldest winters. I have fished your stormy seas. I have trapped your lakes, your rivers, like my father. Happy memories of my childhood follow me where'er I roam. You are mine, great Alaska, and you'll always be my home.
Thank you so much for joining us for Heartbeat Alaska. Native news and native entertainment. Let's make 1998 a special year. Let's clean up our villages. Stop smoking. Let's really do it. No more inhalants and drugs. Let's take charge of our lives. And remember, the children are watching us. I look forward to the video that I hope you send in 1998. Hey, make that a resolution, would you? That you'll send Jeannie Green video from your village. God bless you. We love you here at Heartbeat Alaska. Have a fabulous week, and I'll see you again next year.